Nice. But dang. Yeah, it looks good too.
Hey everyone, welcome back to JR Pro Shop Vids. Today we're going to take a look at the brand new Hammer Black Widow Ghost. So normally I'm the guy who's on the lane doing the reviews for the Hammer brand, but today we got a special treat just for you. So joining us from Winnipeg, Manitoba, we have a Masters finalist and a Canadian national champion, Mitch Huppe. So this new Black Widow Ghost features a pearl version of the Aggression cover stock that's on the Black Widow 2.0. And both balls feature the iconic gas mask core. So as far as expectations go, so I think this Black Widow 2.0 is going to be a little bit earlier, dig into the mid lane a little bit, and be a little bit more predictable down lane. Comparing it to the Black Widow Ghost, I think you're going to see more length through the front and more down lane motion. So to better show the different reaction shapes we can get out of this Black Widow Ghost, Mitch actually drilled two of these, one pin up and one pin down. Patterns today, we're going to bowl on two different patterns. We have a house shot in carbon at 42 feet, and we have another 42 foot pattern in autobond, which is actually sport compliant, it's 3-to-1 ratio. This Black Widow series is a very iconic line, but will this Black Widow Ghost add to the legacy? Let's find out on the lanes.
What's up guys, it's Mitcho, official new member of the JR Pro Shop team here, and today we're throwing the new Widow Ghost. Gonna be starting on the house shot lane. Gonna compare it to the older Widow 2.0, the solid cover. And let's see how it fares. So the house shot here hooks a lot, so I'm probably gonna stand like pretty deep, like 25. Yeah, let's see how much the 2.0 hooks. Typically start with a solid ball anyway, so we'll start with this. All right, good start. I hooked a lot. Okay, so right off the bat, I think I'm gonna switch to the pin down ghost. I don't think getting it to hook enough is going to be a problem, so let's just see what this does on a fresher pattern, see if it's too much or not enough. So I'm going to stay in the same spot. Looks pretty good. Definitely hooked. I mean, it looked earlier than this, and it's probably just because of the layout. Oh, I mean, I like what I see with just the first shot. Yeah, I really like where that's rolling. Right in the right part of the lane, for this pattern at least. Now let's go to the pin up one. I expect this one to go a little further down lane. Probably something I'd use later, like a step down from the pin down one. But it is house shot, so it might look okay. Again, I'm gonna stay on the same spot. Yeah, that one definitely went further down lane. Don't know if I'm a huge fan of the entry angle off that shot. I think it's might be just a little too clean, if I was going for score at least. Let's see if I can move like 3 and 2 left. Let's see if it still gets around the corner. Yeah, no problem at all getting there. And that was 3 and 2 left. And it was pretty steep, but dang. Looks pretty sweet. Reminds me almost of like the Pink Widow. Maybe like a tad cleaner, a little smoother, but that's the kind of vibes I'm getting from it so far. Yeah, let's just keep pushing it. I'll do the 3 and 2. Maybe? Yeah, all right. Well, we found the limit at least. 6 and 2 off a strike, or well, I guess 6 and 4. Probably not the best move. Gonna try the pin down from that spot. See if this one picks up a little sooner. And this is still like 6 and 4 left of the last time I struck with this ball. All right. Well, maybe I can't stand on 42 on fresh. Okay, so I think I'm gonna try the solid now from that same spot where the last two, just a little too light. Probably just too clean of a cover. Hopefully this one doesn't do the opposite where it hooks too early and doesn't get around the corner, but let's see. Yeah. Yeah, if I'm gonna stand there, that's probably the ball to throw, but probably not necessary. Switch to the pin down ghost and move right off of where I started. Just increase the speed a little bit, see if I get my angles a little more closed. I'll move four right of where I was kind of lined up with this ball. Yeah, it looks good too. A little more up the back so I could keep it in front of me a little better. Bumped up the speed and I like what I see. Gonna try the pin up one from there. Might be a little too quick for playing that far right on a fresh pattern at least, but we shall see. Yeah, ball's definitely too quick to play that far right now. Pin up one is definitely a further left and slow down versus the pin down one, I can play a little further right. Okay, I'm gonna try the solid from further right now. Oh, solid's a lot of ball, at least for this pattern. Like I said, the house shot here hooks a lot, so I don't know if hard and straight is necessarily my go-to on this. I think the solid two is just a little too quick, a little too much ball. So let's actually take this pin up one and I'm gonna move back left. See if I can just slow down the speed. Yeah, that's definitely the better spot for that ball. Pin down one lets me play a little further right and the pin up one definitely a little further left. Let's try going, you know, opposite end of the spectrum. We'll go left and see how far left we can get with this. Maybe do another four and two. Nice. Yeah, I can get pretty far left with these balls. Let's try the pin up one from there. Again, yeah, another four and two left, and I'm just trying to keep my speed down because I know the ball's gonna come back as long as I throw it slow enough. Oh, mixer seven. Yeah, it's a little too clean probably. And we'll try the pin down one, same spot. Can already see a pretty big difference between the solid, because the solid and the pin up one are laid out basically the same. Yeah, that looks pretty amazing, not gonna lie. Again, the pin down one just read the spot a lot better. The pin up one just didn't quite read as early as I'd like it to. At least, like I said, like it's pretty fresh still, so. Pin up one would probably be like a couple games from now. Keep pushing it, we'll go another four and two. And again, just keep trying to keep the speed softer. Yeah, I have like no worries about these balls making it back. I think as long as I keep the speed softer, slower, it's gonna get there. Oh, what even hit that? Okay, so we're halfway through the video, about to switch over to the challenge pattern, but got a question for you. Have you ever owned one of the Widow balls? And if so, which one was your favorite? I know my favorite was the Pink Widow, but this one so far, it's making a good argument. All right, I think that's enough strikes on the house shot. Let's take them to a real pattern now. All right, so now we're on the Audubon pattern. It's actually the same distance as the house shot we were just on, and same volume to an extent. The only real difference is the ratio. So what I mean by that is, the house shot we're on was on a 10-to-1 ratio, which means there's way more oil in the middle and way less on the outside, a ratio of 10-to-1. That makes it so when you miss right, it's gonna hook back because there's less oil on the outside and more on the inside is gonna hold. So when you miss left, you hit that 10 ratio and it's staying online longer, it's staying in the pocket. Now, the one on the left is 3-to-1, which means there's a 3-to-1 ratio of oil and dryness. So less hook to the right, less hold in the middle. Just makes it less forgiving, if you will, when you miss. So again, I'm gonna start with the solid, the Widow 2.0. Again, I would typically start with a solid ball on a fresh pattern. I'm gonna stay in the same spot as the house because I know this sender hooks a lot. So we'll see what happens. Yeah, so this one's hooking a lot less, but that's okay. I still like the shape of it, so I think if I just slow down from there, we'll be okay. Ooh, we love the messengers, but again, not great. A little bit of a struggle getting there, probably too far left, so I'm actually gonna move right and probably get my speed back to a little more normal with that ball. Hmm. Still having some trouble getting there. Right, I'm gonna go another 2-1. Yeah, that's a lot better. Yeah, probably started a little too far left. Okay, so I like that line with the 2.0. Let's see what the pin down ghost does from that same spot. Oh, yeah, that looks good. I really love where that ball's picking up, the pin down ghost. I've always been a really big fan of the shiny pin down ASIMs. And this one, it's gonna be a staple, I already know. Let's do the same thing and hopefully we get 10 and not a crush 7 again. Okay, trip four. That's good, trip fours are great. Trip fours mean you have good ball motion. And I'm gonna throw the pin up widow. I expect it to just, yeah, go longer. Might not get there, but it's okay, we'll see. Yeah, just a little quick, it got there, but not a fan of how it's going through the pins from that far right with it. Okay, I think I'm gonna use the pin up one, and I'm gonna move left and just slow down, try and get it to the pocket. So I think that's where this ball is gonna excel. Is when you gotta get a little further left, maybe slow down, maybe not, depending on how burnt up it is, but I feel like this ball is definitely better from left versus the pin down one. So I'm gonna move back another 4 left, kind of where I started with the 2.0, and just throw it slower. Yeah. Yeah, that ball is gonna be great from there. And just for comparison, let's try the pin down from the same spot. So yeah, that one just rolled a little too early, I think, for as far left as I am. And let's try moving right. 42 feet, I don't typically start too far right on it, because I like to play a little further left and play with my speed more on longer patterns, but sometimes right's the answer. So move a good amount right, and just like the house pattern, kind of increase my ball speed to keep it online. Okay, so that's a possibility too. Now, if I was gonna stay there and it started to hook a little too much, maybe burn up in the front, I'd probably go to the pin down widow. So let's see if I can play a little further right with the widow as well, the pin down one. Yeah, just a little too clean. And let's just see what the up one does. Don't know if I'm a big fan of those balls with speed. Don't really see myself using pearl balls and increasing speed. Usually those two don't necessarily go hand in hand. Let's do the fun part. Let's move left and slow down. Actually gonna start with the 2.0. See if I can get a little further left, slow down. Let's just go like 8 left of where I was kind of ideally lined up. Slap the 10 out. Not sure if I'm 100% convinced with that strike. We'll try the pin down ghost from the same spot. See if it goes to the pins a little bit better. Yeah, it's 100 times better through the pins from that far left. And the pin up one. I still got there, but maybe it's a little too clean, a little too weak. The pin down one's definitely the one I like the best from that spot. Let's go another 4-2. And again, just slow down a little bit to make sure it gets around the corner. Okay, that might be the limit. I'm done. Send it back to the shop.
So we're back from the lanes. I had the two Black Widow ghosts comparing with the Black Widow 2.0. And right off the bat, I loved what I saw. I love what I saw from the two that I drilled. I love how they played off each other, and I love how they played off of the solid, the stronger version. First of all, in the house shot, could basically strike from anywhere with these ones at least. Definitely better from left, I think. Just because they're the cleaner cover, you can't play, at least I couldn't play too straight with them. Just the high rev rates, a lot of friction, they were great from left. I could hook the ball from anywhere, it felt like. A great ball down from this one. And then on the challenge pattern, I saw a similar thing. Like, so it was a longer pattern, which again, typically with longer patterns, I play a little further left. And
I loved what I saw from them. Once this one kind of got a little lazy, kind of reached its maximum, I could tap right into this one, the pin down ghost, and picked up in a similar spot, but got to the fronts a lot better. And then when I got further left, I could go to the pin up one, which just got a little further down lane and really let me get around the corner. I would absolutely take at least one of these with me to a tournament. I'm not sure which one. It might be depending on the pattern if I know what it is. My gut tells me the pin down one just because that's the shape that I like to see a little better with a little earlier roll. But if I know I'm bowling on something longer, I'd probably bring the pin up one because I really liked how it reacted once I got to a certain point left. And it's hard to find that sometimes, a cleaner cover with a stronger core that you can get left without it being too lazy. And I loved that out of the pinup one. I think in general, this ball may be better for somebody with a higher rev rate. From the way that it clears the fronts but retains energy, probably do a stronger layout on somebody with a lower rev rate who likes to play a little further right. Again, depending on your house shot and just what you like to see out of the ball. But my initial gut impression is somebody with a higher rev rate will fall in love with this ball. I also love the way that the ghost played off of the 2.0. So I think if you have this ball in your bag and you get to a point in your league night or in a tournament where this one starts the two pin, flat 10, this is definitely the next step down. Tains just a little bit more energy, but still gives you the same shape more or less. I like these balls on a longer pattern just because of this core strength. I think that's where they'll really shine. This one, I think, could also be used later in the block, like on a house shot or maybe something 38, I think, at least, or longer. I think it just may be a little too strong, a little too quick on something shorter than that. But once you get longer and longer, I think this ball is going to be great, especially at the end of the block. Like I said, where you have to get left, you have to slow down, get a ball that you know is going to clear the fronts, but you still need that back end motion. I think if you were a fan of the Pink Widow when it was out, you're gonna be a fan of this one. They're very similar. This one just maybe a hair cleaner, but overall this gives me the same exact vibes as the Pink. I think another option for the Ghost is throw a little bit of surface on it. Maybe tied with a stronger pin. It might be a little more versatile, let you play a little straighter if that's what you like to do. Thanks for watching. Again, let us know if you've owned one of the Widow series balls, and if so, which one was your favorite? And make sure to stay tuned for the next video. We're doing the track heat.